so much for staying with us. Now, we understand that Nairobi nurses are currently demonstrating outside the governor's office. Nairobi County nurses are accusing the Nairobi Metropolitan Services of giving them empty promises. They claim that pledges of promotions, improved allowances, and payment of salaries on time continue to be disregarded. And they say the only way to implement this was through a strike. Now, Beldine Waleola is there and now joins us live. Beldine, good afternoon. What exactly is going on?
Good afternoon. We are here at Nairobi Governor's office where the nurses in Nairobi County are striking. They're claiming that their salaries are not being paid on time, they're not being promoted, and also they want to be paid their allowances monthly and on time. So today is the sixth day since their strike started last week, and they're here blocking their way, hoping that the governor will hear their cries. So I'm here joined by the secretary of NAN, Nairobi County, Mr. Boaz Onchari. Welcome. Who is leading these demonstrations here at Nairobi? Just tell us, why are you coming to the streets today?
Sorry, I'm Boaz Onchari. I'm actually the chair of Nurses Union in Nairobi County. And not the secretary. Number one, today we are here as health professionals. We are not here as nurses alone. We are here as health workers of Nairobi County. And we are here because of the notice that we gave our employer that there are injustices in this county that have not been addressed. So those are the issues that we have always advocated for. And we gave him a notice and he has not shown any goodwill. That is why we are out. We are out so that our employer can address the issue of stagnations. We have our colleagues who have stagnated in one job group for more than 10 years. We have our colleagues who have worked for 5 years and their payslip still reads probation. We have our colleagues who have not been promoted and we don't have a medical cover. So those are the issues we want our employer to address before we resume our duties.
But Mr. Boaz, I hear that today you had a meeting with Nairobi Metropolitan Services that you declined. Why did you decline today's meeting?
You know, it is laughable because in such a crucial time, you don't wake up one morning at 7 a.m. and then you draft a WhatsApp message that we are having a message at 8. Most of us don't live within the CBD. Even if I was to live within the CBD, it will not take me 30 minutes to prepare from my house, ensure that everything is okay before I make for that meeting. So they had the whole of yesterday. We never met yesterday. They never made any communication. They never made an attempt of seeing us. And then they wake up one morning at 7:30 to give us a text that they want to see us at 8 a.m. It was not possible. That is number one. Number two, in their communication, they are saying that we are meeting the HR NMS. We demanded on Friday when we had a meeting that for us to move forward, let us have a representation from the county. Let us have a representative, or rather the secretary of the county, and a representative from the county public service board, so that we are able to iron out issues and find a long-lasting solutions. Remember, they are on record telling us that they have the money, but they don't have a payroll for them to implement. The payroll is with the county. So if they want us to hold meetings with them without the other party, then how are we going to solve these issues? So it is not possible, and it is not going to work. Let them bow to the reality that even if they don't want to engage the count, it is none of our business. For us, we are not choosing on who will address our issues. We were not there when the deed of transfer was being signed. We were not involved, and we are not politicians. We are healthcare workers. All that we need is our issues to be addressed.
Don't you think that you're doing injustice to Nairobi residents who are depending on your services in hospitals?
You know, we are not from Tanzania. We are also Kenyans. We are not from Uganda. The same challenges our colleagues are facing are the same challenges we are facing. Remember, I've told you we don't have any medical cover. Today, if Boaz or any kin related to Boaz was to fall sick, depends on the hospitals that where we are not serving right now. So if we, the people, we are also suffering because we are not at our workstations to attend to ourselves, even to our colleagues. So let it not be like when we are out, Kenyans are suffering, but when we have injustices, it is not something to be taken about.
Yeah. Also, besides the nurses, also the clinical officers in Nairobi County also striking. And here I'm joined with the chair, Kuko, Nairobi County. Why are the clinical officers striking besides the nurses?
Thank you. For the first time in Nairobi County, we have discovered that we need to join hands to fight the injustices our healthcare workers are facing. One, it should be noted that this is our sixth day on strike. and our employer, actually all these guys, what they are only asking for is their August salaries. When it comes to issues of promotion, discrimination and stagnation, these are issues of policy. And what should happen is policy implementation. So the government is failing the people of Nairobi. Our employer, both Nairobi County Government and NMS, are totally failing the people of Nairobi because they are not implementing the policies in place, and that's the reason why we are on strike.
Okay, thank you so much. That's from the chair of KUCO and also the chair of NAN, Bonzo Chari, saying that the strike will continue until the Nairobi Metropolitan Services keeps their promises by paying their salaries on time and giving them promotions that they need. Back to you.
Indeed, Baleula. Belding Baleula, thank you so much for that. She is updating us on the very latest.